5.5% a year. And good news is, India's large population. I remember a time when I was growing up, when I was in school. Now, we had this association called FPAI, the Family Planning Association of India, which used to do massive campaigns, which used to run massive publicity campaigns, wanting to make sure that India controls its population explosion. But good news is, India's large population is not a matter of concern anymore. Our population is now stabilized. It is growing at 1.2%, much lower than what it was 2 decades ago. In fact, India now has so many young people that this is now called the demographic dividend. Just to give you a sense of what I'm saying, if you look at India today, 1.32 billion people, more than 50% of India is less than the age of 27. More than 65% of India is less than the age of 35. So imagine the kind of opportunity, the kind of optimism, the kind of entrepreneurial spirit that can really take India to the next level, provided we all aspire and we all collectively put our intellect together. At one point of time, India's population was considered to be a bane. But now, like I pointed out, this demographic dividend, this young India today, in a knowledge economy, can be called, it's a huge blessing and a boon for the entire country and also by extension for the entire world. Population dividend, in popular parlance, is nothing but young people coming together, is nothing but large demographic dividend that I talked about, is nothing but all of you coming together, putting your collective intellect to make sure you come out with solutions for popular good and for societal benefit. We cannot help but notice that the youth of this generation are a brave lot. I was just hearing, I just had the opportunity to hear Sri Charan speak for the first time. The most impressive thing about that speech, the most impressive thing about how he presented Stumax to you was fearlessness. There was no fear. You know, they say public speaking, in fact, according to a survey, me saying this, public speaking is apparently, the most dreaded thing in the world, even more dreaded than death itself. But what I really liked about his speech was that he was fearless. He had no fear. In fact, one piece of advice, because many of you, I'm sure while you want to create employment, while you want to create more jobs by being entrepreneurs, some of you may also end up being job seekers. The one biggest thing that is going to help you in achieving your goals, achieving your dreams is being fearless. When you go for an interview, ye maan ke chalo, ye maan ke interview table pe pahunch jao, interview room mein pahunch jao, ki agar mujhe naukri nahi milti hai, to uska loss hai, mera loss kuch nahi hai. It is that person who is going to interview me, who is going to be at the receiving end, who is going to actually, lose out by not hiring me. That's exactly what he was pointing out. When he said, please send a text to somebody if you want to intern, saying, if you don't hire me, you're going to lose out. That should be the spirit. Because when you walk in with that kind of mindset, that you have nothing to lose, that you have nothing to fear, then the real you comes out. The conversation that you have to yourself, that you normally have with yourself, that will come to the fore, that will enable you, that will help you in being fearless, in communicating extremely, extremely potently. The future of India, and I'm sure you've heard this many, many times in the past, the future of India is most definitely in your hands. One of the founding fathers of the United States of America, Thomas Jefferson, he said, apparently, he believed that each generation looks at itself as a distinct nation. If we go by what he believed, with so many young people in our country in India, we are looking at a completely different and transformed India. It is a new India altogether. There is a great sense of optimism, yes. There is, like I said, this generation doesn't hold itself back. My young son, who's 13, he is, when I was growing up, I can relate to that age and, that at that time. When I was 13 or 14, If I had to speak to my father, I would be extremely, you know, I wouldn't say I would be, you know, I would be scared, but I would definitely think twice and be very circumspect before saying anything or before uttering anything that might, you know, not be very respectful. But today, my young son who's 13 doesn't think twice, you know, doesn't hold back. When it comes to sharing his feelings, when it comes to sharing, saying something directly to my face, whether or not that is something that I would like or not, he wouldn't think twice. Now, I would say our youth is far more literate today than any previous generation, and more importantly, the economy is also growing rapidly as you grow, you know, not older, but as you grow in your careers as well. But the fact is, we still have many challenges, and our Chief Minister, our honourable Chief Minister, Shri K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu, you know, when I was a part of his team as Minister for Information Technology, he always used to ask me one thing. He said, you know, whenever we went to him with new solutions, whenever we started talking about T-Hub or startups or, you know, anything that is fancy in terms of technology, he used to ask one question pointedly. He used to say, will this actually have a positive impact on the society? Will this solve a problem that I currently face in my day-to-day life as a common citizen? If the answer is no, then you might as well, you know, rethink about how, you know, you would come out with your next solution or next entrepreneurial idea. Fact is, India as a country today has n number of challenges. For those of you who are looking for entrepreneurial ideas, for wanting to do something which is going to not just benefit you, but also the country, you might want to start looking around. For instance, when I became a minister in the initial days, when we were sitting together as a team, we said, okay, what can we do using technology to solve the problems of a common man? You know, I'm sure many of you here have your own motorbikes, and you ride them to college and back home and to a lot of other places as well, right? When you typically ride a bike or, you know, drive a car, you know, police, a traffic cop will stop you once in a while and will basically check for all the papers that you're supposed to carry, a registration card, an insurance paper, and of course your driver's license. So in initial days, when we assumed office, when the new state of Telangana came into being, we said, how can we solve this problem? So we threw this challenge at one of our young startups here, who walked up and said, I might come out with a solution. The startup was called Radical Tribe, and they came out with a solution. They came out with a digital wallet, and we called it M-Wallet, a mobile wallet. The Road Transport Authority immediately liked it. So along with the traffic police, along with the transport authorities, this young startup came out with a solution. So as long as you had a smartphone, you could have all these three pieces of document, all stored electronically on your phone. So whenever a traffic cop stopped you next time, all you had to do was flash your phone, and if he had a reader which could scan through, then immediately you were off. So these are the small, ingenious, small, you know, interventions which will make your startup idea an extremely successful one. Let me tell you, this application, this app has been downloaded, the RTA M-Wallet has been downloaded more than 20 lakh times already. So that goes to show you the power of the small utility which can help, you know, ease the pain point of a common citizen and at the same time give a huge fillip to your entrepreneurial idea. See, today's youngsters, all of you, you're not content in only being a job seeker like the generations before. You're not content in securing a government job for life. You're not content in actually staying in a job for very long. You know, we used to have lifers. You know, whenever I meet some people who say, I've spent 30 years in, you know, government service, or 30 years in Mahindra and Mahindra, or, you know, 25 years in Ashok Leland. And when I share that experience with some young people like you,